Welcome to Concentrate on Cold Brew by Alliance Brew Gear, where we explore the world of low and slow coffee extraction, whip up some cold brews here and there, and ultimately help you jumpstart your cold brew game. I'm Nick Tracy, and this is Concentrate on Cold Brew. We hope you're having a great day in the cafe. In this week's episode, we'll talk about the economics of cold brew, why shops should be selling it, and why it doesn't hurt to brew at home as well. At Alliance, we often hear this statement from coffee shops.
We don't offer cold brew because it's expensive, takes too long to prepare, and just isn't worth the hassle.
While cold brew does take some advanced preparation and use more grounds per batch, if you hear me out, I think you'll find that you're missing out if cold brew isn't on your menu. Beyond the shop, specialty coffee fans will find that cold brew is easy to do at home and is a great way to have great coffee on the go. Let's say you're a coffee shop and you've just made your first batch of cold brew. The beans you're brewing with cost you $10 per pound, a high estimate for a roaster, but reasonable for a shop that buys their beans from a roaster on wholesale. And you're brewing a simple concentrate of 1 pound of coffee for every gallon, in a 7-gallon bucket. You'll yield a little over 6 gallons of concentrate because grounds retain a lot of water, and you'll have spent $70 on beans. At this brewing ratio, we recommend a dilution of 1-to-1, meaning that half of your drink is cold brew concentrate and the other half is water, milk, or ice, perhaps with some room left for cream. Because of this, that 6-gallon yield will get you 12 gallons of final product. That 12 gallons equals 128 12-ounce drinks, or 96 16-ounce drinks, sold at $3.50 for a 12-ounce drink and $4.25 for a 16-ounce drink. This batch will equate to sales between $400 and $440, assuming you serve a combination of the two drink sizes. Subtracting the cost of the beans as the primary cost of goods sold, you're looking at $330 to $370 of profit. In the first batch, you will already have recouped the cost of the brewer, filters, and covered the recurring costs of ice, cups, cream, and labor. Speaking of labor costs, isn't cold brew more labor intensive than traditional coffee beverages? Our answer is a resounding no. While it does take more time all at once to brew a batch of cold brew versus a single pour over or latte, when divided across the number of beverages served, you spend far less time on the single batch of cold brew than on an equivalent volume of individually brewed hot drinks. Let's make a broad generalization and say that it takes about 1 to 3 minutes to make an individual hot drink in a cafe. This is only accounting for the active labor time of brewing, so grinding beans, tamping, pulling an espresso shot, steaming the milk, and pouring some quick art for espresso and milk-based drinks, which can be done in about 1 minute by a seasoned and skilled barista, but will realistically take 1.5 to 2 minutes in practice. Or grinding the beans and brewing in a pour-over, which will take about 3 minutes total. In contrast, if you're really taking your time on a batch of cold brew, the active labor time is about 20 minutes, maybe 30 if you're being meticulous. Assuming we did a similar concentrate to the previous exercise, we have 12 gallons of end product to work with that only took 20 to 30 minutes of active labor to brew. The hot brewed beverages took 1 to 3 minutes per 12 or 16 ounce beverage to prepare, so multiplied out to 12 gallons, you're looking at roughly 2 to 6 hours of active brewing time depending on the skill of the barista and the spread of drink types and sizes ordered. The average barista's hourly wage is $10.28, but let's overshoot that in an effort to consider something closer to a living wage and set it at $15. That wage multiplied out across the hot brewing times is about $30 to just shy of $100, versus the cost of brewing an equivalent volume of cold brew sitting around $7.50. That's some serious savings. The time saved opens up your barista to tend to their other duties and engage with customers, promoting a less stressful environment for them and, by extension, your customers. To be clear, we're not advocating that you remove hot brews from your menu, but rather showing that offering cold brew as another option can lead to a more balanced schedule and less frantic cafe. Keep in mind that if you brew a ready-to-drink, or RTD, batch or a smaller volume of cold brew, you'll need to brew more often for a similar volume of end product. However, Even in a small batch ready to drink brew with a 3.5 gallon yield, you'll still find that it's beneficial. Applying the same concepts we went over earlier and negating the 1-to-1 dilution, you'll still end up with 28 16 ounce beverages, or around 37 12 ounce beverages. For simplicity's sake, we'll assume that the beverages are sold at a similar price for 12 and 16 ounce drinks, but it wouldn't be unreasonable to increase the price per cup of your RTD cold brew to reflect the higher flavor quality of the beverage, especially if you used higher quality beans. However, given a similar sale price, you'll still end up with sales of $120 to $130, subtracting the cost of the beans, around 40 bucks, the generous half hour spent working on it, and about $2.50 for the recurring costs of filters and cups, you've got $70 to $80 in profit. For roasters, there are some great ways to include customers in their cold brew program beyond buying it by the cup as they stop by. Growler programs are an increasingly popular method pioneered by the craft beer scene that allow you to sell larger quantities at a reduced cost per ounce. This benefits the customer if they want to have it at home, share it with their friends, or are looking to save some money by buying it in bulk. We'll also talk more about growler programs in our episode on marketing cold brew. The other method of including your customers in your cold brew program beyond the cafe is small batch brewer bundles. Offering a 2-quart cold brew system that is bundled with a bag of your coffee is an excellent way to add value to your program. This will encourage your customers to experiment with brewing your coffee as cold brew and become a repeat customer of your wholesale beans. Now, from the customer side of things, how does brewing cold brew at home benefit you financially? Let's say a 12-ounce bag of beans from your local roaster cost you 15 bucks. If you're brewing a simple 1-to-1 dilution concentrate, you'll use about 8 ounces, so 2/3 of the bag, or $10 worth of coffee. This will get you roughly 1.5 quarts of cold brew concentrate to be diluted with an equal volume of other liquids, leaving you with 3 quarts of final beverage. This means you've got 6 16-ounce or 8 12-ounce cafe-quality cold brews at home for the price of 2 or 3 drinks in the cafe. For the ready-to-drink recipe, you'd simply cut the amount of coffee used per batch in half and not dilute with anything, but brew it twice as often. The value per drink is the same, minus the effort of brewing a second batch for an equivalent volume. There's a good balance to be struck between brewing at home and enjoying cold brew made by your local coffee shop. There's definitely room for both. Are you an owner or an employee of a coffee shop? If so, how do you go about pricing your cold brew? If you're a fan of coffee and cold brew, how often do you brew at home versus purchasing drinks at your favorite coffee shop? Let us know in the comments section below and let's get the conversation started. Thanks for watching this week's episode of Concentrate on Cold Brew about the economics of this delicious beverage. We'll be back next week to give you guys some basic brewing advice and recipes to build off of. I know I mentioned our concentrate and RTD recipes earlier. That means ready to drink, but we'll explore them more in greater detail then.
What's going on, everyone? No crazy announcements this week, just a friendly reminder to check out the Cold Brew Alliance group on Facebook. See you there.
In today's episode of Concentrate on Cold Brew, please consider liking this video and sharing it with your friends. It really helps the channel out. If you want to connect with us, various coffee roasters, cafes, and other cold brewers, the link to the Cold Brew Alliance page is in the description. Click or tap the Alliance logo to check out the rest of the Alliance Brew Gear channel. Catch up on the rest of the Concentrate on Cold Brew videos over here, or watch the previous episode right here. Again, thanks for tuning in to Concentrate on Cold Brew, and stay caffeinated out there, my friends.